In order to provide the correct solution, there are key pieces of information we need to obtain. This will ensure that not only we offer the correct solution, but also the most cost-effective. In this training video, we will guide you through the process of filling out the tensioning tool fit checklist. We will also explain the reasons why we asked for the information and what issues are caused when designs are created without these specific details. This next part of the presentation will guide you through four sections of the checklist: the requirements, what each mean, and why they are required. Knowing the application gives us the opportunity to cross-reference it with any past projects and solutions. A design may have already been created for this application or something similar, which could help speed up the quotation process. This should be a universal inquiry specific reference, which is recognised by the customer, customer centre and product company. Advising who the end user is enables us to check history of relevant past projects, inquiries and end user specific requirements. Advising what industry the inquiry is based around will highlight industry specific standards and safety regulations. This might affect the design and intended handling of the tool. Knowing what the tools are being used for can help determine if there are any previous solutions or case studies in which we can share to help you with the inquiry. This is the opportunity to give additional information to help us offer the best solution for the inquiry. From this information, we know that time is important to the customer. So bolt tightening solutions would look to propose a tool that can give the customer a time saving. This measurement gives us the size of the bolt. The pitch is the distance between two threads. This is the distance between two flat sides of the nut. This is the distance between two corners of the nut. This is the length of stud which protrudes from the nut. Bolt tightening solutions advise a minimum of 1x diameter. If the stud protrusion is less than the diameter, then the thread strip calculation will need to be performed. You'll need to contact the Bolt Tightening Solutions Centre in order to do this. Not every application will have a washer, but if one is present, we will require the following details in order to design the tool bridge at the correct height. In this example, there is no washer on the application. However, this is the distance of outside diameter of the washer. This is the thickness measurement of the washer. This is the quantity of bolts that are on the joint. Having this information gives Bolt Tightening Solutions Centre the opportunity to advise on the number of operations and how the customer may be able to save time. If the nut is round or special, the Bolting Solutions Centre require additional details. The distance between two bolt centres. Distance between the bolt centre and any rear obstruction. Distance between the bottom of the washer and nut and the top of the obstruction, if any. This will give us an indication on if the tool can be mounted onto the stud and highlight design limitations. Distance between centre of the bolt and the welding radius, if applicable. The bridge of the tool will need to sit on a flat surface. This gives us the opportunity of knowing the radius or angle and if we would need to sculpt the bridge for the tool to fit onto the application correctly. Distance between the centre of the bolt and the edge of the joint. This information is required to check calculations to make sure the tool can be used in a safe way. If there are any other obstructions that have not been given, these would need to be stated. There may be an additional obstruction that only affects part of the joint, but these are often overlooked and need to be considered at design stage. The two types of load that can be given are initial and final. The final load, also known as the residual load, is the load that is required when the joint is completed. Our designers can then calculate additional load required in order to overcome load lost through joint relaxation, also known as load loss factor. The initial load is the load applied before the relaxation of the bolt. No further load needs to be calculated if this is given.